has everything. Bumping and banging.
Big boy.
Big boy.
All righty, man.
Yeah, baby.
Getting all legendary up in here and show you right. Oh, yeah, and Quik's here, too.
Oh, yeah.
Show you right, man. Yeah, best believe that. We got the one and only DJ Quik up in here, man. How you doing, Quik?
Doing great, man.
Show you right, brother.
Yes,
you smiling and everything.
Look at that.
Yeah, you know what I love about Quik? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? What I love about Quik, man, Quik, you know how to put your voice into that octave. Like, when you record or when you do shows, there's a Quik octave that you can't run away from.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But when you talk to Quik off air, like, when he's doing a show, he not, unless, you know.
But
when you talk to him, oh, he's like, hey, what's happening, man? You know, he's real Barry White-ish. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah. Hey, what's up, Big? How you doing, man? You get that new record? No, but you know what, Quik? You always been a cat that understood exactly what your fans wanted. What they wanted to hear. You know what I'm saying? You perform your records just like you sold them to us.
Yeah, man.
And it seemed like you were a fan of DJ Quik's first. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Are you?
Yeah, man.
Really though.
I love me, dude.
I heard
when
that.
When I get on stage, it's like I'm talking to you now. That changes. It's like, it go up here.
Yeah,
it's like, hey, come on, y'all, let's go. Turn up. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, see?
Check it out.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of the time, I'm feeling fancy free. You know what I mean? It's just.
Get this. No, just, you know what I'm get the instrumental. But you know exactly what we want when you get up there, bro.
That's you got to do it. You got to bring it.
Hey, man, now, Quik, it's been many calendars for you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And a successful career, bro.
24 years.
What's one of those things, man, that keep Quik going? Because you got to think about this. Think about back in the days. Think about flyers. Think about concert announcements.
Wow.
Think about commercials that used to play on radio. Think about how many people you've done shows with. And no disrespect to them, but a lot of cats aren't here now. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, what do you think was that staying power, especially Quik, in a business that, you know, you're here today, you're gone
tomorrow. This is easily
they want to chew you up.
Industry.
You know what I'm saying? They want to chew you up. And then when you deal with just life situations, and you one of those cats, Quik, where it wasn't about just DJ Quik. It was a lot of people eating with you or off of you or, you know what I'm saying?
You saw that.
Yeah, in a major way.
Amen.
So you had a lot to say, you know what? I'm gone. What made you continue to stay and bear this thing called music and the music business?
Well, number one, I had to end the whole free lunch program. I got rid of the lunch tickets.
But you went back and gave those tickets out many times, too, though.
Yeah.
Because you'd be like, man, I'm done. And then I'd be like, all right, cool. And then you'd be like, yeah, we doing one more.
No, I had to. It had to become more about me. I mean, being a producer, you kind of always think about the artist you're producing and what's best for them and trying to make music that makes sense for them. Mm. But after a while, I just got overconsumed in other people's stuff.
Right.
And it's like, hold on. I'm DJ. I got a career, too.
Yeah, man.
So I had to save some for me.
Right. Do you ever feel like, man, I got a career and it's better than yours, too? No.
Yeah, I mean,
what am I doing?
It's a great thing, man, being a producer. I mean, when you think about it, just the people you get to work with, like the stuff I've been doing recently, I can't even really talk about it because I know he don't want me to talk about it. But I've been in the studio with some heavy cats, seriously heavy.
They calling you now, huh?
Yeah,
you heard that.
Go ahead.
They're like, man, you over there talking about him?
Yeah.
What the hell is going on?
See,
now, what's going down with DJ Quik, the artist, right now?
I got a studio now, not a home studio, none of that. Got a real studio. And just being back in a real studio, like you're back in a real big studio.
Yes, sir.
What I mean? And you know how it is to have people around you that depend on you, you know what I mean? So I'm in a studio doing normal stuff, like cleaning the carpet,
making it
an easy place to, you know, smells good, you know,
because
the sound is taken care of. I got the sound down pat.
So now you're just working on actually cleaning the carpet.
Keeping the carpet clean, you know what I'm saying? So when people come in to work, it's just fly. Everybody get into their celebrity mode and get on that microphone and get it.
We're going to come down there and see this clean carpet,
too. Yeah.
Come on, man.
I
got a Hoover. I bought one of the Hoovers.
Oh!
Get the chemicals from Home Depot.
Let's not say Hoover too much. They're going to think we gang. Tonight they're doing Unsung.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
and I'm going to tell you straight up, Quik, I am an Unsung guy.
Man.
Like, I watch every one
episode,
of them.
Me too.
And not just because I know Quik. You know what I'm saying? And when I watch your Unsung, you always learn something about someone in every Unsung. But when I watched yours, it was like I knew you, but then I got to a point where there was a lot of stuff I could shake my head on, like, yeah, I knew that.
Right.
And then there's other times when you'll watch and you'll say, damn. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Were you first skeptical about doing an Unsung?
I didn't. That it would have been done in like 2011 if P. Frank had his way.
Right.
You know, P. Frank Miller approached me a few times. I see him on, you know, on planes and in the airport, and he'd be like, "Man," he'd be talking fast. You know, "Man, we need to do an Unsung on you, man." I'm like, "No, no, not yet."
Why not?
Because Unsung kind of makes it look like it brings up the things that you don't really know about people that they don't really want you to know.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, man, I don't want to be that open. Like, right. I already done shared some stuff. I overshared on the radio one time with y'all.
Many times.
I was talking too much. Y'all had to take me off the radio. Like, Quik is an open book. So I didn't really,
music,
you know,
also, though.
I shut that down. Remember, I wasn't doing radio or nothing. But when P-Frank brought it to me, with P-Frank, I figured that, I guess, you know what? There is a lot of misconceptions that, you know, I need to clear up myself, you know, because, you know, people started to form these opinions about me. Oh, he's emotional. Quik is emo. And, you know, why does he wear his hair like that? All these crazy stuff. Is he gay? Is he this and that? This just kind of just puts the whole capstone on it. And, you know, I've shared, I'm sure it's things on my Unsung that people ain't even going to remember that I did, you know. So it's pretty much just I'm open. But I'm real cautious, too, at the same time.
You know what I enjoyed about it also, Quik, man, is that...
That you were in it?
Not just that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, who else were they going to get to talk about?
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm telling you, man, I could have did a whole hour myself. You know what I'm saying? Like, they used a lot, but then there was other things. I'm like, man, they didn't use that other great moment from... But this ain't about me, Quik.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Is it because I can talk more? Okay. But the one thing that I was kind of... When I looked at it, I was like, man, I'm glad you did do it. Because we always say, oh, man, you know, dude was a legend. You know what I'm saying? Then we start playing mixed records and, oh, man, when he was. And that's why I tell cats, man, we got to celebrate our legends or celebrate people while they're here.
Yes.
Hell yeah, man.
While they're right here as opposed to saying, oh, man, you know, such and such. Did you hear? Or we're going to play five songs in a row, which we do. And I understand that. But I'm so glad that you said, you know, and you told it yourself.
Yeah.
Because we can sit down and continue to tell stories in our herds and so on and so forth. But you always put things in music. You know what I'm saying? You bared your soul in music. You've told us certain things in music. When you come and do interviews, you speak. But this is one of those where it just kind of felt different. And if anybody's going to talk about Quik, it had to be Quik. You know what I'm saying? And it closed up a lot of misconceptions.
Thank you, bro.
And closed up a lot of books.
It's an awesome episode.
Yeah, it is.
It ended some chapters in my life that don't even need to be reopened.
Right. And you know what I love, too, man, is that you could have went, and you know, personally knowing you also, you could have went into a different direction at a certain time where you was like, you know what? I'm not going to speak on this person, that person. Speak on me.
I'm grown.
What I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So I thought it was a great, great Unsung. And you know what's crazy? We know the catalog. But then when you start to hear it again,
I was a bad mofo, dude. I was on. I was hard, man.
I was
killing.
Like, oh,
come
my
on,
God.
Let's get down, safe and sound,
oh,
way too funky,
man.
Just like Compton tonight. Just to hear them records and see that, it's like that energy, that was West
dude,
Coast.
Dude, the videos, you know what I'm saying? And really just taking us also out of the hood, too. Like, when you went out of the hood, even though, like, now we would say, oh, man, you know, Oakland. Like, Oakland, when I was young, Oakland sounds so far away. You know what I'm saying? Like now,
and
I'm saying, oh, Oakland. But when you took us from Oakland to Denver, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And St. Louis, and it was just like Compton, I had never been anywhere. So when you went and said, man, we getting on buses, we doing this, we doing that, and it's just like home plate.
Yeah.
I went on those trips with you through your music. Hey, Quik, do you run away from the term legend or legendary?
Yeah, you know, see how it's uncomfortable. Like, because legend just sounds like John Wayne was a legend.
Right.
You know, and that just sounds...
To some.
Old.
Right.
You know what I mean? Sound like, and you know, just old. Like, you know, I still jump around on stage.
Yeah. Oh,
you know what I mean?
Tell me about it. Still make great music.
Thank you, boss.
You know what I'm saying? So do we say legend or do we just say Quik?
I guess, you know, I mean, I don't call like people like Dr. Dre a legend.
Right.
You know, because he's always in your face.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I guess I kind of earned that title for being like reclusive. I'm here and I'm not, and I'm here and I'm not. And if you look at if we can go back to the Unsung for a minute, just the things that I survived, every time it got good for me, my family would do some weird things, man. I walked around this building. I used to be executive vice president at A&R at Warner Brothers, and I can't believe my sister kicked that pork chop off my plate. She got up and blocked it like DeAndre Jabbar. Get that out of here.
Hey, man, that's another thing where I'm like, Quik, man, How do you keep sanity in a business that's ready to tear you apart, in a situation with family or friends, whatever it may be, passerbys?
Like I said at my Unsung party, the viewing party, P. Frank asked me how, you know, about the Tupac and the Biggie thing and how I was able to, like, still be around when that was a very tumultuous time. I said I had to learn how to say, you know, right there when it got super weird, I had to learn how to be like, okay, that's enough. I'm leaving.
Right.
And exit the building because it's just going to keep getting weirder and weirder. So I just had to learn how to walk away from a bunch of things.
Are you happy with where you are right now?
I'm so happy, dude. It's like I sleep, I eat, you know, I exercise, I drive my car, ride my bike, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. But it's different now because I don't have all these mouths to feed, and I don't got people depending on me. You know what I mean? It's like I pretty much told everybody to go. You're grown. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I don't have a job for you. I can't afford to pay for what you got going on. I'm not investing in no more harebrained schemes. You know, hood people always got a scheme or whatever. I just had to shake everybody. Like I can't be accessible like that.
Do you feel like people think you've changed?
You're damn right, because I don't get to talk to you. I changed my number.
I heard that. I know I tried to call you a couple days ago.
It's gone.
Yeah,
done deal.
Like, man, I hit you with a text, and I was like, man, he didn't reply. So a few days later, I called you, and I was like, ooh, all right.
Yeah.
Must be shaker season.
People emailing me mad. Right. You changed your number. Yeah. But on this email, it says sent from my iPhone. Yeah, What's that about?
Now you still on that. You know what I'm saying? I was just like, oh, I'll catch him in the sun, moon, or stars. I'll see him. I had to book this interview just to get his phone number. Father's Day is this Sunday. Mm-hmm. And I always talk about this, man. We're doing Father's Week up in here, man. Quick, great father. You know what I'm saying? And it's always good when your kids can speak about you, too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? When they say, hey, that was dad, and we knew what he did, but he was always there. Even in your Unsung, they speak.
Right.
Because sometimes, if they would have put my dad on an Unsung, they would have been like, hey, how'd your dad be? Like, man, fuck him. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Then it would have been like, I would have been like, which one is he? They would have been like, this him. I was like, oh, I'll cut that. I've never seen him. Let me take a look. You know what I'm saying? But Father's Day is going down, man. Mm-hmm. And I just want to celebrate the dads. You know what I'm saying? Man. Not taking anything away from the moms out there. Yeah, we know the moms, man, the best human beings, the best creatures ever created.
Absolutely.
But we want some of that shine, too. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You walk anywhere in the mall, go somewhere today, Quik, you're going to see something that say dads and grads combined.
Right.
It's going to be on the same flyer. It's going to be on the same billboard. You know what I'm saying? Because it's dads and grads season. But you never see moms and proms.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Mother's Day is the same time as prom season. But we don't say moms and proms. Not that we have to.
Right.
I want to just separate. I've been doing this petition for the last 6 years. I only got 12 signatures on it. You know what I'm saying?
Nobody's
with it. Yeah. Yeah, so it's getting bad, man. It's getting bad. What are you doing for Father's Day? Nothing?
My kid, no. This is the thing. Every day to me is father. I ain't gonna be corny with this.
Don't
every
come
day
with
is
that.
Father.
Every
you know,
day
look,
is
look,
father.
Wow.
Because
that's
we
what, that's
listen.
What
this
say.
Is what's sad yeah. yeah. about it. They don't. They take us for granted. I wish
okay,
they would
I,
take
okay, I know
Father's
saying,
Day off of the calendar because it's the most meaningless holiday ever. Yeah. I get on Mother's Day. I have more fun on Mother's Day.
Tell me about it.
Hooking up my mom, yeah. hooking up the wife, or whatever.
I eat better on Mother's Day.
Absolutely,
it's hilarious.
It's happy. On Father's Day, here I get this American's greeting card with everybody signing it.
Yeah.
Miss Mac handwriting. And it's,
yes,
this is
sir.
A bug.
Yes, sir.
This
yeah.
is some bullshit.
And my wife, she, you know, sometimes I see my kids didn't even sign the card. I'm like, man, you signed Jaden and Jade's name on here?
This is the most worthless holiday ever.
Yeah, man. Aww. And we're not bitter, ladies and gentlemen.
Nope.
We just talking
not
about
all.
It. We just, you know, sometimes you got to tell people how to, you know, how to take care of you. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I don't like that. I like, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So we're just doing that. Just speaking it into existence, man. Louis, when you have some kids finally,
yeah,
man.
One day.
We fighting this fight for you. You
oh,
know what
really?
I'm saying? We fighting this fight for
Looking
you.
Appreciate
man.
The dad.
Yeah.
yeah.
So when
yeah,
you get
man.
There, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you
hopefully.
Understand what we've been through.
Well, thank you.
You know
man.
What I'm saying? This is the movement. This is the,
yeah,
the daddy rights movement that we're
the
going
daddy's
through.
Rights
the daddy's rights
movement.
Just when we get all the rights and we can vote and eat, don't just go out there and use the N-word and all that. You know
okay.
what I'm saying? Like how we did our ancestors that fought for us and we just totally fucked it up.
I'm glad I don't have to worry about any of this.
Say what now?
I'm glad I don't have to worry about any of this because I'm not going
to
be a dad.
No, but you got to take heed to this.
I take care of my dad.
No, I'm talking about even when, not just dad, Mystery Matt, her boyfriend.
Okay.
Oh, she has a boyfriend that we don't know.
A boyfriend we never met.
Never, bro.
But when Mystery Matt, her boyfriend is named Matt, just yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. You know Matt, right, Quik? Yeah.
No, not
you know,
at all.
No, you know
Matt. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Matt.
Everyone
yeah,
knows
yeah,
Matt.
Yeah, so when you and Matt, when y'all have kids, you know, take care of them
I
for
will,
Father's
of
Day.
Course
what you doing
I
for
will.
Your dad's for Father's Day?
I'm going to take him out to brunch, and my sister is doing, on Saturday, is going to take him to the Dodger game.
Okay.
So they're going to spend time at the Dodger game, then Sunday I'll have
Now, is this
them.
A Dodger game that he got to buy the tickets to? Yeah, he got to drive
it's,
and buy the Dodger
Dogs. Tickets that he bought the season tickets.
See what I'm saying?
See?
Taking him on his tickets.
This is so not his original. I can have brunch by myself. Every Don't day. Take me to lunch. I've been paying for food for the whole year.
There's a brunch up the street every weekend. You know what I'm saying? But now, this weekend is called Father's Day brunch.
Absolutely.
Every other weekend is called seafood brunch.
And they bumped up the price.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And then let me tell you, Mother's Day, I called for the brunch.
Yeah.
Couldn't get in. Father's Day, I called, I'm in. They're like, what's your party? I just named a number. I said 78. They was like, we can do that. Because nobody's coming down. Y'all stick around your radios, man. We got DJ Quik up in here who's not paying attention because he's looking at his phone.
This phone is going crazy. People is popping up at my house. Hey, I'm at your house. Wait a minute. Get the fuck away from my door.
It's that Unsung. Y'all stick around your radios. We got DJ Quik up in here, y'all. We just celebrated Tupac's birthday.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? Absolutely. What did Pac mean to you?
Super cool friend. More energy than I ever seen, and I'm a hyper dude, but Tupac was up on the... I stole his live performance when I used to see him jumping on speakers and rocking it seriously. I copied that from him. I never seen nobody rock like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a martyr. You know, I hate even get a chance to have kids, you know, and leave us somebody that could follow in his footsteps like Easy did. But he's forever alive because of that music. When you hear the songs, it's like he's not gone anywhere.
You know what's wild about that, Quik? We were just talking about this on his actual birthday. We were saying, man, next year is 20 years since the passing of Pac.
That don't make sense to me.
Yeah, there's because people that's Pac like... fans that weren't even born.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? But that music, that legacy, that catalog, it's like it's right there and it's a moment in time that continues to grow with you, though. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Like, you can listen to Pac and it doesn't sound...
dated.
Exactly.
We did our thing in the studio with that All Eyes on Me. I jumped in and went hard.
What was that like working with Pac?
It was. It went by too fast, number one. That was the fastest 2 days I ever remember being in. It was like a roller coaster.
I heard he worked in the studio. He worked.
He would come in, sit down, listen to the beat, stand up, get a pen, light a blunt, write the lyrics to the song right there on the spot, go in there, check me out quick, test 2, 1, 2, 2, push record, and he's doing the whole song. Like, jeez. This is insanity. I can't believe I'm watching this, but hey, get another beat. Let's do it again. Let's go again. Come on. If you on, like, it was almost like he was like Daryl Strawberry. Like, you just throwing the ball, and he just hit it out the park. He was just knocking him out the park. Then he'd go in the studio with Dre, do the same thing. Then he'd go in the studio with Johnny J, do the same thing. Then he'd come back to me. Then he'd come back to me with a Daz beat that he just did.
Like, did you know you were watching a legacy?
Nope.
Nah.
No, because... I was into my shit.
Right.
I'm over at the other studio working on Safe and Sound. You know what I'm saying? So I was busy, but.
Hey, man, can you tell the story about Sugar Free? You know, like Sugar Free, one song that he was blessed with is Why
You Bullshit.
Exactly. Yeah. Why You Bullshit.
You want the real story?
Yeah, just how he would write. And now, you know what I'm saying? Like, explain it, because you had a chance to give me a bar of this. Explain that to the people.
I never did this on the air.
Please do.
All right, DeJuan, I'm putting you out there, man. Sugar Free.
You already put him out there when you said DeJuan.
Oh, so
that's the beginning.
Sugar Free would come to the studio, right? And he'd be feeling some kind of way. He'd be up. And I'll play the music. He'll put the headphones on. And then he'll start dancing like George Jefferson, you know, the beat to have him moving. So he'll write the lyrics down. He'll get the pen. He'll put it to a side. And he'll write some lyrics. Right, while the beat is playing, the instrumental's playing, here, look at me, look back at his pen, writing, and then he just go, boom! And he just slammed the pen down and just take the headphones off and just run around the room. Like, I did that! That was it!
Damn.
Nigga, I'm it! Yeah. I'm like, bro, like, and then I go over there and peek to see what he wrote.
We could write this song a lot quicker if you just stay down and finish this damn song.
He's his biggest fan.
Hey, man, how did you know, like, was How You Bullshitting, was that a record for Sugar Free, or was that a record for someone else? Or
I did that beat. I wanted Tupac to have that beat because I knew he would kill it, but he didn't live long enough to get it, because I did it like right after he was finishing Culluminati, right? So, but that was my first choice to have it, because it would have been like Hearts of Men Part 2 with some Indian stuff going on. I wrote that beat at High C's apartment in on Otsego in North Hollywood.
Hello.
Yeah, no, in the room with the Dayton's in it. You know, that's when niggas used to keep their wheels in the room so they won't get stolen.
Or put a little table on top of it.
Absolutely. Like, yeah, make it a table, four tires. But I wrote it over there, and I called Sugar Free. I called Tone, like, man, I want Free to hear something, right? So he came to my house and listened to it. And he's like, man, I gotta have that. Mm-hmm. You gotta let me have that. That's right there. I ain't gonna disappoint you. Right. I got you. I'm like, all right, because this is, you know, I know when I got a good one.
Yeah, man.
This is hot. So as soon as when he heard it, he just, oh, why you bullshitting? And I'm wondering where he's going with this. Baby, why you bullshitting? Get your money, why you bullshitting? I'm seeing him just grooving. He was counterpointing the sitar. Baby, why you bullshitting? It was just like, it just had you bouncing. So he wrote the lyrics there on the spot, and he kept doing that animated hook, and he was imitating Al Green in the background. And if you listen to it, he was on, man. That was, boy.
You know then?
Yeah, I knew. I knew he was on.
Hey,
drugs.
Man, let me tell you, man. It was one thing with Sugar Free. Sugar Free was one of those cats, man. Yeah. I didn't understand it.
Yeah, right.
First. You know what I'm saying?
It was hard too, but it was different.
I had to go back on the real, man. I had to go back and grab the album again because I had the album before. Yeah. And then I was like, you know, if you stay ready, you know. Yeah. But I didn't catch it.
Right.
And then it seemed like, I was like, oh, okay. I remember I had to go back ahead of his time.
Yeah.
Real walkie-talkie.
A pimp.
Ahead of his time. And I had to go and get it back and listen. And like, oh, okay, damn. And since then, dude's been fired. The same thing with E-40. That was the way I was with 40 Water. 40, I've been rocking with 40 for the longest.
Yeah.
But early on, I had a homegirl. I was like, yeah, this 40, this E-40. I was like, and I gave it a listen, and I was like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I think it was more of her putting too much on it.
Yeah, like, let me fall in love with the record myself. Yeah.
And then, man, boom, that's another one of my guys. Quik, what do you want to get out of this whole game before you say, you know what, I'm done with it?
Shoot, a Dre Beats deal.
I heard that.
I need something to pay for my existence.
Really?
I don't want to think about money.
Hey, Quik, do you ever think, like, man, like, and
I ain't never seen Dre so happy. Man. You see how good he looked?
Oh, man. Yeah.
In the studio,
man.
And like, man. Right. You look like money.
Yeah. You know what? And it's a trip, man, because Dre smelled different.
Absolutely. There's something going on,
yeah,
ain't
there's
it?
Yeah, there's something going. Yeah, he smell rich. Like, there's a couple cats. I remember I told Jay-Z one time, I said, man, you smell rich. And then I remember he was walking with Oprah one time, and Oprah told him, she said, you smell like you have money. You smell rich. There is a
smell.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, people come up to me, they say, man, you smell good. But I get this from the mall.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's not. Yeah, I get this scent from the mall. I don't want to say what it is, because I don't want everybody going out smelling like me.
Yeah.
But it's not this thing where it's this club of smelling rich that people are in that I haven't quite gotten into. Do you feel like you're underappreciated, Quik? Without saying it for you, I mean, it's hard for you to answer that. But do you feel like, man, like, I could see you do a record, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I say, man, people don't know what he put into this, where he's getting his sound from, what he's using on his analog board, where he's getting a sample from, or how this dude is playing this. Like, you are a producer that produces a record. And it's not like there's somebody that come in and they, you know, oh, let me get that beat. You know,
right,
oh, let me put my name on it. You know what I'm saying? And some cats do that, with no disrespect, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But do you ever feel like, man, like, the value of people don't understand what you do?
I'm sure they don't. I mean, I think it goes over their heads. Like, because I come from the school of listening to records like, you know, Street Songs, Rick James. Mm-hmm. And these records have multiple layers in them. It's not just a two-track in stereo. It's like there's layers of music that you can hear that you don't automatically pick up. So I do that now where I put, you know, you got a bottom beat, you got a bass line, piano, whatever it is. And then on the inside of the track, off center, it's like other things happening. Like, it's a world, a circular sound, as opposed to just straight two speakers.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I do. And people don't get it. Like, they feel it sometimes, you know, something to jump out on the side of the speaker and be like, whoa.
Yeah.
You know, stuff like that, panning, little stuff. I think that's important. I think it makes for not so boring records.
Did you ever think, like, man, let me just make it simple. You know what I'm saying? Like, even what people would think is the simple stuff,
right?
Uh-huh. You make difficult. You know what I'm saying?
I try not to. I mean, but I guess that's me competing with myself.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to go bigger than the last, you know, oral, you know, piece of art that I wrote. It's all sound art to me. You know what I mean? And again, I credit that to NWA. Them records used to be panning, and that panning made them more special than the other records that were out at that time.
Mm-hmm.
The other records were just, everything was in the middle. Some things are loud, some things low, and that's it. But, you know, the way Dre and Yella was putting them pan and gunshots and hi-hats and all that, I wanted to do that. And, I'm still on that. It don't matter now as much as it did. No, I don't think it's appreciated.
Right.
No, but I don't care.
you know, again, I've always been a little bit ahead of my time, and I ain't trying to toot my own horn, but that's kind of what it is. I'm a great producer. I'm one of the best producers that ever lived.
Say it, brother. We agree with you.
Are you looking forward to the Straight Outta Compton movie?
Yeah, actually, I am. I've been looking at the trailers, and I just can't wait to see how accurate they portray Eazy-E, because I spent a lot of personal time with Eazy.
Yeah.
And I just want to see if it was like...
You know what? I asked Cube and Dre the same question, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, is this a movie... And I'm so glad that they're a part of it.
Absolutely.
Because hopefully with them being there, they could dictate it well. As opposed to, oh, you know, somebody else is doing the movie, so on and so forth. But also with those movies, it's never, and I hope it is, but sometimes it's never what you think it's going to be.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I can't wait to see this. But of course you can't take all those years and put it into
condense
a movie.
Condense them into 2 hours. Yes.
You know what
Possibly.
I'm saying? But I think the right guys... are doing this movie.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? And they had to look out for each one of them the same way they had to look out for Eazy. So
well,
I really want to see that.
They are, Dre and Cube are responsible for that legacy.
Yeah, man.
You know, so many people were branched out of that is crazy, that are still coming up today.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like that NWA, I mean, think about it, Eminem.
Oh,
you
yeah.
know, Snoop.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like, you know, the whole thing.
Yeah, there's a hell of a tree when you start connecting like the
Yeah,
50s,
when you collect
the
dots.
Like, yeah. Yeah, that
billions
is crazy.
Of dollars worth.
Do
of
you remember, man, DJ Quik? Now it's like with and you know, I love where it's at right now. But remember back in the days, it was like, oh man, that's LA shit.
Yeah,
that's Cali
when it was
shit.
Regional.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, like regions. You know, yeah. Oh look at them, man, the gang banging, which was crazy. Look, oh, they're wearing khakis. You know what I'm saying? I remember even times where cats be like, man, he got a perm.
Oh
you
yeah,
know
they bagged on me.
And now cats are in khakis. They got perms.
Look at
they got low riders. You know, they got braids. You know what I'm saying?
When they hated on it before.
That's crazy.
We set the trend.
Yeah,
I mean,
man.
Think about it. What better place is there to live than California? Let's just kind of be honest. I've been around the world. I'm on my fourth passport.
I
still keep coming back here to renew it.
I heard that, brother.
Aww.
I heard that. Yeah, take us with you, Bracken.
Yeah,
man. Motherfucker.
I got two stamps.
Yeah, you
Jamaica
know what
and Jamaica.
Yeah, this dude. Hell yeah, man. I got four passports. And I keep coming back here to renew it. Bye, Big. I got a tour. I got to get to Czechoslovakia. They're having problems over there. DJ Quik, definitely want to thank you for coming in and
man,
hanging out with us, man.
This man, Big, I couldn't
Stay
wait.
Stay legendary, man.
Yes,
thank you,
man.
Bro.
Stay
Please.
Legendary, man. And when I came to Real 92.3, the first thing that I did with my kickoff when I moved is I told Quik, I said, Quik, I need a jingle from you. So anytime in my career, people say, oh, what was the first? I know when I came to this station, I know the first record that I pressed play on, 100%. And I called for it. I was like, Quik, I need a jingle from you. I'm in a new stage in my life. Not even a new chapter.
Yeah.
A new book.
Absolutely.
And you helped me start off a great situation, bro.
Dude,
I needed
so awesome.
You on that, and you came through with it, bro.
Man, I see the bigger picture. You know, don't get it fucked up. I hear you on your sister stations, like the Beat 101.1 in Phoenix,
yeah.
and
mm-hmm.
Luther Lufay, and
I
you know what I'm saying,
it.
and do MC Duke Dirty.
You know what I'm saying? He need a.
I'm gonna give you a beat for that.
Too. Yeah, can you imagine? That's when your whole career go down.
Come on.
Me and Quik, we're making it sick. We got a female, and yes, she's thick. Yeah. You're like, man, you hear that shit, Quik DJ? And I'm like, you produce, man. But thank you, brother. I appreciate you.
My God.
Continue to live, continue to be legendary.
Man,
yeah.
Can I say one more thing before
I continue to salute you.
Love you.
I'd rather
buddy.
You not. I'd rather you not. Thank you. That was it.
I just want to say, happy birthday to Tupac. Rest in peace.
Okay, I got you on that. Cool in the game, brother. I was about to,
out.
Man, it was so prolific what I was saying.
Yeah,
but you
man.
Came back with a more prolific-er.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? No, DJ Quik up in here, man. Big boy.
Big boy.